Jesus loves you!
All right. Now, during Jesus' brief ministry, he had a reputation for power and authority. When Jesus spoke, demons fled, storms ceased, and dead people came back to life. At his touch, sicknesses vanished and bread multiplied. Thousands of people gathered around to cheer him on and hear him preach, and tons of crowds would gather and call him the Messiah. But before we go into the rest of our story, I want to share with you guys one other king who kind of did things a little bit differently when it came to serving. This king thought he was the coolest king ever, and he did things differently when it came to serving compared to Jesus. So let's see exactly what this king did.
You ain't nothing but a
Presley, king of rock and roll. Uh-huh. Yeah, I'm pretty awesome. I've had a lot of successes in my life. Money, fancy cars, girls, awards. Name it, I got it. Right. I even had enough money to buy these blue suede shoes here. Thank you very much. Looks like I got a mark on my new shoes. All right, who stepped on my shoes? I thought I told you not to step on my blue suede shoes. Don't worry, honey. I got servants just for that reason. Where are my servants at? Aww. Yeah, I'd say my life's pretty awesome. I have people do everything for me. Why? I have people fan me and feed me. That's what you get as a king. Servants. Don't get me wrong, I love having servants, but I could never dream of doing what they have to do. Can you imagine shining people's shoes all day or fanning them nonstop? No. No, that's not for me. You missed a spot. That's better. Well, now that my shoes are shined, I can get back to my hard. Out of my way, ladies. It's time to have some fun.
Wow, that was so cool that Elvis came to visit us today at One of a Kind Bible Adventures. Yeah. But I don't know about you guys, but I think he seemed just a little bit proud. He thought that because he was the king of rock and roll, he didn't have to be a servant to people. Instead of him helping people, he had people help him. That brings us to our story for today. We're talking about Jesus being a servant to his disciples. One day there was a huge Passover feast. And once everyone came, Jesus did something amazing. He washed his disciples' feet. Now, a lot of you got a ride to BBS today. Back then, they didn't have cars or bikes, and all the roads were really sandy and dirty. Everyone wore sandals, which means that their feet got pretty disgusting. And whenever they would show up at a friend's house, it was usually the job of the lowliest servant to wash the guest's feet. So I bet you can understand why the disciples were a little bit confused and didn't understand why Jesus was washing their dusty feet. You know, there are some things that happen in life that we just don't understand. Kind of like this. Why Jesus was washing their feet. Why would the Son of God, a king, stoop down so low and wash the disciples' dusty, gross feet? Well, let's go ahead and take a look and find out. Amazing Passover feast, but I would love to start off tonight's festivities.
Sorry, I'm late!
What were you doing?
Nothing, I just didn't want to come, so I procrastinated.
Thank you, Peter, for just barging in like that.
You're welcome.
Like I was saying, I want to start off tonight's awesome festivities with our annual White Elephant Gift Exchange.
We've never done this before.
What? Sorry, you have to use the microphone.
Why?
We can't hear you if you don't. Yeah.
I said, this is not annual. We've never done this before.
I can't even believe we're doing this.
What? You have to use the microphone, too.
Oh my goodness. Enough with the microphones. They're not even turned on.
All right. Like I was saying, let's get back to our gift exchange. First up, here we go. We have a gift to Hannah. From Judas. Heads up, it's jewelry.
Seriously, Judas, you are the most shallow, self-centered person I've ever met. Did you really think that jewelry would... It's a tiara! I have a tiara! Put it on me, put it on me, put it on me.
All right, there you go. You look beautiful.
Of course I do. I'm a princess, and this is my tiara. Someday my prince will come.
All right, with that done, we're going to go on to our next gift. Let's see. Oh, awesome. To Judas from Peter. Thanks, bro.
I didn't get you anything. I just found out about this.
I'm pretty sure you... You got me Bible glasses.
How did you know? I didn't buy that.
Oh, yeah, I know. Don't worry. I bought it for you. I used your Bible bucks.
Happy Passover to myself.
I hope you're kidding, Judas.
Hey, guys, let's take a picture of Peter using my new Bible glasses.
Please don't take a picture of me right now. You're not supposed to cooperate. What are you...
Nice. Look at his outfit. He looks so dumb.
How much for the glasses, Judas?
I mean, well, like, if you like, take in tax and, I mean,
get on with it.
1,000 Bible bucks, but it was on clearance, it's okay. Like, it's all good, like, debt-free.
Clearance does not help.
Seriously, Judas, you're a lot of things, but I didn't think a thief was one of them. You know what? I don't think anything is safe anymore. I'm gonna hide my tiara.
No, you can't. That's mine.
No, it's not. It's mine.
No, it goes on my fireplace at home.
So you're saying that you gave me something, so then when I leave, you're just gonna, like, take it back from me?
No. I'm gonna take it back before you leave, because I'm gonna have to chase you down later to get it back.
I think I wanna go home.
All right, and that was our annual gift exchange. What a success.
What are we gonna do now? I'm bored.
Hannah, of course you're bored. You're a boring person.
Oh, I got it. How about we play a card game?
That sounds like fun.
You know, I think I might just have the game. Mary, come here.
Okay. Okay. Don't want the instructions. That's pretty bad.
Alrighty. Here we go. Pick a card. No, not that one. Yeah, okay. Alright. Memorize your card. Do you have it memorized?
I do.
Are you positive?
Yes.
Show it to the kids.
Y'all got this?
Yeah.
Got it?
All right. You guys said it out loud.
Don't say it out loud. That's cheating.
Here we go. Is this your card?
No, it's definitely not.
Oh. Okay, well, if, here we go. Is this your card?
Yes, oh my God.
Really?
No.
You know, I'm sure I could just, like,
Judas,
shuffle them and they would be...
You're awful at cards.
But...
Nope, stop. No more.
Okay, so, a better game. How about we play Rock, Paper, Scissors, Lizard, Spock?
That sounds like fun. How do you play?
Okay, so it's really simple. Okay, guys? So, scissors cuts paper. Paper covers rock. Rock smashes lizard. Lizard poisons Spock. Spock smashes scissors. Scissors pokes lizard. Lizard eats paper. Paper disproves Spock. Spock throws rock. And as always, rock crushes scissors.
Nailed it. How about we not?
Well, okay. Shouldn't Jesus be here by now?
Yeah, but you know, we could probably just start dinner without him. I mean, he's gonna get here eventually, right?
Dude, why do you have a tiara?
A grown man should not have a tiara.
What are you talking about? Tiaras are made
for It's
no,
not.
They're not. They're made for princesses.
Maybe I want to be a Disney princess when
That's
I grow
not,
up. Men do not have tiaras. That's not a thing. It could be a thing. I can make
Hey, everyone. Sorry I'm late. Camel traffic.
No, it's cool. You know what? Let me find a microphone for you.
Oh, just sit down, please.
Come join us, Jesus. I saved you a seat.
Thank you, Anna. Before we start eating, there is something I'd like to tell you. I consider you all to be my brothers and sisters. I love you very much. You've done so many great things for me. You followed me, believed in me, and you stuck with me through the hard times. In return, I want to do something for you.
Jesus, you're too late. We already did the gift exchange.
I'm not talking about that, Peter.
Dude, we've done that like a couple times this week. I'm pretty sure that's not it.
No. Wait. Ew, your feet.
Do we have to drink it?
It's so gross.
And it has kind of gross feet.
Ew. Ew. Like, this is gross. What? Why would you guys do that, though? I mean, that's not like Jesus.
Wait, Master. Why are you washing my feet?
You may not understand why I'm doing this now. You will soon enough.
I can't let you wash my feet. Not ever.
If I don't wash you, then you won't be clean. You can't be a part of what I'm trying to do.
I can't? Then by all means, wash my feet, wash my hands, wash my head.
You only need your feet washed now, and then you're clean all over. My concern is holiness, not hygiene. There, now you're clean. Not all of you.
What?
Do you understand why I did that? You call me teacher and master, which is what I am. So if I, teacher or master, wash your feet, then you must now wash each other's feet. You must now serve each other. I've laid down this pattern for you. If you understand what I'm saying, then live it out and live a blessed life. Now, speaking of that gift exchange, Judas, where's my gift?
When Jesus washed his disciples' feet, that was just his way of showing his overwhelming love for his friends. I'm sure that the disciples didn't understand why Jesus was washing their feet, but even though they didn't understand, Jesus still loved them anyways. Jesus' perplexing act of love modeled the way that we should reach out to others. Sometimes God might ask you to do something that you just don't understand, or maybe you just don't want to do. But even when you don't understand,
Jesus loves you!
Awesome. Let's go ahead and bow our heads, close our eyes, and pray. Lord, thank you so much for this day. Thank you for loving us unconditionally. Lord, I pray that whenever we're faced with times we just don't understand, you'll help us to remember this story. I pray that you'll help us to find new ways to serve the ones that we love as well as each other. We love you so much, Lord. We pray all of these things in your name, and everyone said, Amen.
Amen.
Well, you guys were amazing today. I cannot wait to see you again tomorrow for another one-of-a-kind Bible adventure.